Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, and today I am starting a impromptu weekend reading vlog. So I'm by myself all weekend, I have nothing to do, and I thought this would just be the perfect weekend to read. I am keeping the TBR short, just because I know how I am, and we're just going to be finishing a couple of books and reading volume one of a graphic novel series. So I'll get more into that here in a second, but the books that I am going to be reading is I have probably 130-ish pages left of Quicksilver by Kelly Hart. This is a fantasy romance. It blew up on TikTok. Everyone's been raving about it, and, I'll get a little bit into this later, but I think it's a little overhyped personally, but I am intrigued with the story and where it's going. So, yeah, I'll talk more about that later. And then a book that is actually really surprising me that I need to finish. I have, I think I'm a little bit over halfway through, but I need to finish Warbreaker by Brandon Sanderson. This is one of his first novels that was published, and it's an introduction novel pretty much to the Cosmere. And I'm really enjoying this. Like, it takes a lot of brain power for me to read this book, so it makes me a little scared to keep going with Brandon Sanderson, but I am very much enjoying this. And I'm pretty pleasantly surprised of one of the romances in here. I haven't really started the second romance, but the initial one is actually really sweet, and I was not prepared for that at all. But yeah, so we're going to be finishing these this weekend, fingers crossed. I've been using the audiobook a lot for this because I actually really enjoy it, but it also helps me to do some immersive reading, which is when you read along with the audio, it helps me digest the story a lot more. So we're going to finish this weekend and then finish Quicksilver. And then I bought this graphic novel this morning. I only recently found out about it. It just happened to be in one of the recommended books on my Amazon. And it's called Under the Oak Tree. It's by, the original story is by Suji Kim. It was adapted by Namu and art is by P. I believe this was a webtoon comic. Don't quote me on that, but I'm pretty sure that's correct. Like, there's an initial novel, and the novel's not even out yet, which is surprising. I think it's coming out next month, maybe. I'm not sure. But this, it was adapted to a graphic novel or a comic series online, and apparently it's very popular, so they decided to start publishing it. And look at this cover. Oh my god, it is stunning. And the art inside, like, what's some, okay, excuse me. I'm gonna flip to this page. So you can get an idea on the art style. Like, are you kidding me? Like, of course I bought it. So I plan on reading this today. Like, it's a graphic novel, so it's not gonna take very long to get through, but it's giving me, like, because I kind of started it at Barnes & Noble. I just wanted to get a sense of the story. And it seems to be somewhat inspired. I don't know this for sure, but it has a lot of From Blood and Ash vibes. And I love that first book. The first From Blood and Ash is my favorite book out of that series. And I just like the vibes. And the art style is stunning. So we're going to read this. And see if it's worth continuing. I hope it is. I think it will be. But this is a fantasy romance, so we're doing wonders. So I'm packing, and my apartment is a wreck, so you probably won't see a lot of my apartment because I am currently in the process of moving. So this should be interesting. What else is there? I guess that's it. I'm gonna eat later. And then we're just vibing. So, okay, I'm just rambling, but I'll see you guys in the next update. All right, so I have an ambiance on. We're doing some woodsy forest with a river. And we're gonna read this. and I'll let you guys know what I think. Okay, so I kind of want to just give a quick check-in. Are there any page numbers? There's no page numbers in this, but I'm like a fourth of the way through Under the Oak Tree. And I'm actually really liking it. It's very fast. The relationship has kind of progressed in a very quick manner, but that's okay. So it really gives me like Persuasion by Jane Austen, smashed up with From Blood and Ash by Jennifer L. Armentrout, which is such an odd mixture, but it actually really works in this. So basically, we have our main guy, what's his name, Riften, who was originally a low-born knight in this kingdom. And he marries a lady, one of the lord's daughters. Her name is Maxie or Maximilian. Such a fan fiction name, but I love it. And she has like a stutter and everything. She's very insecure. I hope that changes. Like, that's something that's kind of bothering me. But I think her character arc is going to change over time. And so she and him are forced into a marriage of convenience. That's like from the very first page, so that's not really a spoiler. And the next day, he's gone for 3 years on this mission, and that's where he like gets his status, is from that time. And then he comes back and is like completely infatuated with her, which I think is really sweet. Like, he's a really sweet guy, very like tough, but he has a gentle side, which is pretty nice to see actually. And then Maxie grew up, her dad's is extremely abusive to her, so trigger warnings for parental abuse in this, and like just the degrading and the complete stripping of her person is really sad. And she's real, and they basically told her that if she doesn't make this marriage work, then she's nothing. And there were all these rumors going around that he was going to marry someone else, that he was going to divorce her when he came back from his mission. And that like really fucked her up in the head. And that's kind of where we're at. They're together, they're on their way to the kingdom, his kingdom. And that's pretty much it. We have some side characters here. We haven't had like full-on introductions yet. But I'm really liking it. I like their dynamic a lot. And the art style is stunning. Oh, the art is beautiful in this book. So I probably won't check in again. We'll see. Until I'm done with this. But I'm really enjoying it. And I think this is going to be like a new favorite because I'm actually very much like eating this up.
All right, so I'm here with my final update for Under the Oak Tree. I just finished it and I loved this. It's very slow. Like, the plot's pretty slow, honestly, but the fantasy and all the like juicy aspects of the story, like even the romance and all of it, is gonna culminate a lot more and build up on itself. So if you read this, there's not a ton that goes on in this, but it's enough that keeps you satiated and craving for the next volume. Like, I need volume 2 of this. It doesn't even come out until May of next year, but I could read it for free online. But I don't like to read digitally for the most part, so I won't be doing that. I'll just wait for the next volume. But I love this. I gave it 5 stars. It was so fun. And yeah, I'm excited to be obsessed with a new series. I love these characters. Maxie and Riften are so fun, and I love their chemistry. It is the marriage of convenience, like I said earlier, and they're still getting to know each other. Like, we haven't fully built their relationship yet. There is some spice, but it's not like overtly over the top. I think it's rated for 16 plus. Yeah, it's 16 plus. So
It's not like filthy, but there is a lot of suggestive content in this. But I do think it's interesting. And then, like, I do want to see Maxie really, like, come into her own. She really starts to, but through all the abuse that she had to deal with, she is very beaten down, and she has no self-confidence. So I'm ready for Homegirl to really come into her own. And yeah, we left on a pretty decent cliffhanger, and I'm excited to read the next volumes. So the next book I'm going to be reading is Quicksilver. I'm going to finish it. I have a little over 100 pages left, so obviously that's the one I should focus on. But right now I'm currently cooking dinner. I'm making some meatballs with pasta sauce, and I think I'm going to watch Princess Mononoke, which is Studio Ghibli movie. I really love Studio Ghibli. I've seen Spirited Away, Kiki's, and Howl's Moving Castle. I love all three of those films. But I haven't seen Princess Mononoke, and that's another like highly acclaimed one. So I'm going to watch that. And then I'll jump into Quicksilver, and I'll let you guys know how that's going. All right. Let's get this show going.
What's that?
I've never seen
it. Looks like super donkey piss.
All right, so I just finished watching Princess Mononoke, and it was good. I'm still, just like any Studio Ghibli movie, I am a little confused on some things, but for the most part, I thoroughly enjoyed it. So, yeah, Studio Ghibli is just, you know, it's just such a vibe. I watched Howl's Moving Castle again for like the 10th time not too long ago, and that movie's just so good. It's so magical. So if you haven't watched Studio Ghibli, I highly recommend it. But now I'm gonna go read some Quicksilver, and we'll see how or where I end up. Good morning, friends. Happy Saturday. So I read a little bit more Quicksilver last night, but I got distracted by other things, but I am going to finish that today, I promise. But this morning I'm meeting up with one of my besties, and we're gonna go have breakfast, go to the spirit shop, and then go to Barnes and Noble. So sounds like a good morning to me. So I'll take you guys with me on some of the stuff. I don't know how much I'll vlog, but you'll see at least some of it. It turned out to be half the day that was gone, but that's okay. Spending time with friends is always a good idea. I just want to do a small haul. You saw I went to a few different stores. I did good. I only bought two items today. First was at the spirit shop, and I got me this really cool Ghostface tumbler. It says killing it. And here, if you didn't know, bariatric patients, for the most part, are told not to use straws, but I think I'm getting to the point where I would like to try to use some straws. But even if I can't use the straw, I can just use this as a normal glass, so we're fine. And then at Box Lunch, I don't know, I saw this on the website for Box Lunch not too long ago. Now that was really fun, and I think it would be pretty useful for me. I got a Kiki's Delivery Service bento box. It's just really cute. You have Gigi, you have a bunch of pastries and stuff on here. And I take my lunches to work, and now that, since I am a bariatric patient, my portions are super small. Instead of using those giant containers. This is like really fun sized, and I feel like it would be really good for me to take lunches, and it's microwave safe, and they have different sizes. So I really love this. I think this is super cute, and I will for sure be using this in the future. And I'm tired, so I'm gonna rest for a little bit, drink some tea, maybe try and make some lemonade later. We'll see how that goes. But I'm tired. It's been a long morning, so I'm gonna chill for a while, and then I promise I will get back to reading, I promise. I will finish Quicksilver today if it's the last thing I do. Okay, see you in the next update. All right, everyone, it is currently the next day. Per me, haven't read anything today. It's about 2 o'clock. But I did want to go ahead and talk about Quicksilver, which I finished last night. And I ended up giving it 3.5 stars. I have a lot of issues with this book. I'm not going to harp on this for too long, but like I just feel like the book was just very all over the place. The pacing was all over the place. I just was never able to fully engage in the story. The romance was off to me. I mean, there were some things that were explained later that kind of makes it a little bit better, but nothing that was so groundbreaking that it made me forgive the things that I felt earlier in the book. But I did like the end, and I do think some of the more fantastical elements of the story coming in are very intriguing. And I do think that the second book has a lot of potential, and I will be reading it. But this book was just not what I was wanting it to be, and that could be just a me thing. But I have a good friend who read this also, and she didn't really care for it that much either. So I'm sad. I feel like this book was very overhyped, which is crazy because I usually don't, like, if a book is very hyped, I pretty much am one of the people that are hyping it up. So this is a very interesting thing for me to not be completely blown away by a very popular book. So that's it for this. I'm sad I didn't like it more, but I did like a lot of elements, but it just, a lot of things just didn't work for me. But I will be tuning into the second book because I think it has a lot of potential. So that's it for Quicksilver. Gave it 3.5 stars. And then I am going to go read a little bit of Warbreaker. And I want to try and get that done today. I have about 5.5 hours left of the audiobook. So if I hunker down and dedicate the time, I think I can finish it today. But if I don't, I will try to finish it and then wrap this vlog up. But yeah, so that's the update for Quicksilver. All right, it is about 11 p.m. I'm about to go to bed, but I wanted to go ahead and close out this weekend reading vlog. I'm glad I was able to get through it. I haven't been able to do a reading vlog like this in a while. But I finished Warbreaker about 15 minutes ago, and I loved this book. It was so good. This is my first Brandon Sanderson book. And I'm very excited to jump into Mistborn next. I'll be starting that very soon. But I'm giving this book 4.5 stars. It made me cry. A lot happened at the end. I really love these characters. Ciri and Susa Braun are They're everything. And I'm still digesting the ending of this book. But I really hope Brandon goes back to these, to this world and with these characters, because we kind of, we didn't resolve everything. And we don't know what happens to everybody. And I need to know that information. So I hope he goes back at some point. But yeah, 4.5 stars for this. And just to do a quick recap, 4.5. And then I also read or finished Quicksilver. And I think I'm giving this 3.5 stars. Again, a lot of things that in this disappointed me, but I think it has a lot of potential. Book two in particular has a lot of potential to rectify a lot of the issues I have with this book. But I still think it's fun, and I still think if you're interested in it, go ahead and pick it up. A lot of people are giving it 5 stars, so it could just be me. But 3.5 for this. And then a book that really surprised me, Volume 1 of Under the Oak Tree by art by P, adapted by Namu, an original story by Suji Kim. And actually the novel I found out for this is coming out in November. I don't know if I'm going to read it, because I love this format. I love the visual medium here, but I might go ahead and do that. I don't know. But this was a very great, very awesome 5-star book. It might actually be a 4-star, but we'll revisit that later. But I'm giving it 5 stars because I was very heavily invested in this. And yeah, that was a great weekend. I was able to actually accomplish the things I wanted to accomplish. So I'm happy and I'm tired. So I'm going to go to bed. But I want to thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope you got some enjoyment out of this. Let me know below if you read any of these books, and let me know what your thoughts are. And if you've made it all the way through to the end of this video, put a rainbow for Warbreaker, a rainbow emoji for Warbreaker. And yeah, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.